بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. This is night 20, جزء 21 إن شاء الله تعالى. جزء 21 comes in the last part or the remaining part in سورة العنكبوت, the spider, and then in سورة الروم, the Romans or the Europeans, and in سورة سورة لقمان, and سورة السجدة, and a section or a part from the beginning of Surah Al-Ahzab. Subhanallah, so we have got the last part in Surah Al-Ankabut, Ar-Rum, Luqman, As-Sajdah. So we are reciting from five surahs, Juz 21, inshallah. After the mathal that Allah gave about the spiders, Subhanallah, Allah says, وَتِلْكَ الْأَمْثَالُ نَضْرِبُهَا لِلنَّاسِ. These are the examples that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala presents to the people or to mankind. وَمَا يَعْقِلُهَا إِلَّا الْعَالِمُونَ. And only those who have knowledge, they can reason and they can understand. Allah says and gives a command, أُتْلُ مَا أُوحِيَ إِلَيْكَ مِنَ الْكِتَابِ. Recite what was revealed to you from the book. Recite the Quran. وَأَقِمِ الصَّلَاةِ. And establish the salah. إِنَّ الصَّلَاةَ تَنْهَى عَنِ الْفَحْشَاءِ وَالْمُنْكَرِ. The salah keeps you away. The salah forbids you from fahsha, from zina, from fawahish, from shameful acts, from immoralities, wal munkar, and from undesirable and actions and acts and vices, all the bad things the salah can help you to avoid. So it's a reminder for everyone, and also for those who are vulnerable to the fawahish, for the youth, for everyone who is being trialed by, you know, desires, you know, that keep maintain the five daily prayers. Maintain the wudu, maintain your tahara. Inshallah, this is a way for you, you know, to maintain integrity and, you know, morality, bi-ithnillahi ta'ala, and modesty. Then the first juz in surah, the first ayah in juz 21 is a guideline Allah, the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, was given. وَلَا تُجَادِلُوا أَهْلَ الْكِتَابِ. So Allah says, if you have to, if you argue, don't argue or debate with the people of the book, referring to the Christians and Jews, illa billati hiya ahsan, except in the most beautiful way or in the best way, you know, of argument, right? Illa billati hiya ahsan. So imagine, you know, this is a guidance Allah and teaching Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us to those who are differing with us in with regard to faith. We do have so many commonalities and similarities, but there are, you know, specific areas regarding the faith. You know, it's okay that we disagree, right? You can work together, but if we disagree, if, you know, with regard to some matters in faith, if there is a way of dialogue, you know, we can dialogue that, we can debate and argue, but with what is best and what is beautiful. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions here in Surah Al-Ankabut, وَكَأَيِّن مِنْ آيَةٍ وَكَأَيِّن مِنْ دَابَّةٍ لَا تَحْمِلُ رُزْقَهَا اللَّهُ يَرْزُقُهَا وَإِيَّاكُمْ وَهُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ. Allah says, how many creatures are there that do not carry their provisions with them? Allah provides for them as He provides for you, subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's a reminder that the one who is in charge of sustenance and livelihood and your risk and giving you, you know, resources to live and survive, He is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So trust in Him. There is an invitation or call from Allah to reflect on some of His ayat at the end of Surah Al-Ankabut. Allah yabsutu rizqa liman yasha'u wa yaqdir, sakhara ash-shamsa wal-qamar. Then Allah says, the life of this dunya, وَمَا الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا وَإِنَّ الدَّارَ الْآخِرَةَ لَهِيَ الْحَيَوَانِ. Allah says that the life of this world is nothing but a past time, you know, something just for amusement, for entertainment, you know, for play, but it's not something that remains, it's not everlasting. Allah says, where the real and true life is al-akhirah. Subhanallah. Then the conclusion of Surah Al-Ankabut is, وَالَّذِينَ جَهَدُوا فِينَ لَنَهْدِيَنَّهُمْ سُبُولَنَا. Those who struggle and strive in our and for our cause, we will guide them, and Allah is with those who are doing good. Surah Ar-Rum, which is named after the Romans, begins with a prophecy. Subhanallah, the Prophet ﷺ was informed, and it was revealed to him before this incident would happen, before it happened, that what is this incident was that the Romans, the Christians, were defeated by the Persians. It's something happened in history, and the Quran mentions that, right? We would have more, you know, inclination toward the Christians, right, than the Persians regarding who would worship the fire, because the Christians have a book, would have a book, and they do believe in Allah, in God, you know, even though they, you know, many of them, they committed shirk, and they worship, you know, Jesus, some of them, they say Son of God, some of them, they say He is God, and so many different sects there, but, you know, at least they do have something, you know, some remnant, some references from the book. So Allah mentioned that prophecy, and subhanAllah, it came true. This is one of the evidences on the truthfulness of the Quran, and the wahi of the Quran. It is not from the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, it is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Immediately after that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يَعْلَمُونَ ظَاهِرًا مِنَ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا هُمْ عَنِ الْآخِرَةِ هُمْ غَافِلُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reprimands and speaks about the disbelievers and the polytheists. You would find them have knowledge, they have superficial knowledge about the dunya, about this world, but about the hereafter, they are heedless, they are, you know, zero, ghafilun, they are ignorant. You can find this reality with so many Muslims today, unfortunately. They may know so many things about dunya, about this worldly life, but about deen, about Quran, about the akhirah, they are zero. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us from this heedlessness. Ameen. Allah mentions some about his ayat in Surah Ar-Rum. And actually, one of the central themes of Surah Ar-Rum is to confirm that Allah, it is Allah alone who is in charge of all of the affairs. He is the one who arranges, you know, the time and the life and the night and the day and the riyah, the rain. So these are some ayat are mentioned here in Surah Ar-Rum. Allah says, it is He who originates creation and repeats it, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah mentions وَمِنْ آيَاتِهِ, and amongst His ayat, أَنْ خَلَقَ لَكُمْ مِنْ أَنفُسِكُمْ أَزْوَاجًا. Amongst His ayat is that He created you from dust. And وَمِنْ آيَاتِهِ أَنْ خَلَقَ لَكُمْ مِنْ أَنفُسِكُمْ أَزْوَاجًا. And amongst His ayat is that He created from amongst you mates and spouses. وَجَعَلَ بَيْنَكُمْ مَوَدَّةً وَرَحْمَةً, and He made between you مَوَدَّةً, an affection and mercy. وَمِنْ آيَاتِهِ خَلْقُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ, and amongst His ayat, the creation of the heavens and earth. وَمِنْ آيَاتِهِ مَنَامُكُمْ, and amongst His ayat is you sleep. And وَمِنْ آيَاتِهِ اخْتِلَافُ أَلْسِنَتِكُمْ, the differences or the different tongues. You know that people speak different languages. These are some of the ayat of Allah. No one can make fun of any language. By the way, you have to be careful. You know, no matter what people, how people speak, right? This is one of the miracles of Allah and one of the signs of Allah in His creation. Right, so to the rest of this ayat comes to us a beautiful ayah that I personally love to reflect on. This ayah, what is this ayah? The ayah is about fitra, one of the most powerful covenants and evidence on the existence of God, in the existence of Allah. You know, something that is within every single human being, which is the fitra, the natural innate, the natural disposition, al fitra. The we are the product of Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Himself created within every single human being something inside to crave for God, to think about God. To initially, when a person is born, the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam mentions as well a hadith that reinforces the meaning of this ayah, because the sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam does match and does confirm, you know, does reinforce what Allah says and the Quran as well. Because they both are revelations. So the Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam said, "Kullu mawludin yuladu ala al-fitra." Every single human being is born, or every single new born or a baby is born in a state of fitra. What is this fitra? You know, one of the powerful evidence and proofs that Allah is there. You know, despite of the negative and the vicious campaigns and propaganda against Islam and Muslims, you find some reverts coming. What is this thing that pulls them and attracts them from inside? This is the fitrah, my dear brothers and sisters. And it depends on the level of the purity of this fitrah. You know, based on that purity, level of purity, people would, you know, would match and, you know, follow and try to come to seek for a guidance and light in these times of darkness. So Allah says here, فَأَقِمْ وَجَهَكَ لِلدِّينِ حَنِيفًا. So set and establish your face, you know, in steadily and truly in the deen, حَنِيفًا, يعني inclining to one worthy of worship God, فِطْرَةَ اللَّهِ الَّتِي فَطْرَ النَّاسِ عَلَيْهَا. فِطْرَةَ اللَّهِ, the fitra, and the scholars say this fitra is Islam. This fitra, the natural innate, is love, inclination toward the worthy of worship Allah, which is Islam. You know, Islam is all about, as I said, one-to-one relationship. Believe in one God and believe in all of His prophets and messengers. Believe in whatever Allah revealed, you know, of books of revelation, and believe in all of His prophets and messengers. This is Islam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions that in Surah Ar-Rum. Subhanallah, we have got here an ayah that is, you know, has been quoted a lot regarding corruption in the land. ظهر الفساد في البر والبحر بما كسبت أيدي الناس. Allah says that corruption has emerged in the land and the sea because of what? Because of what the hands of people have earned, meaning sins. Because of transgression and oppression and corruption, you know, people are being tested and trialed. Ajib, Allah mentions here, when Allah decrees a punishment, it is out of His mercy, subhanahu wa ta'ala, to rectify our behavior and conduct with regard to Him. Subhanallah, Allah says, لِذِيقَهُمْ بَعْضَ الَّذِي عَمِلُوا, so that Allah let them taste some of the bad things that they do and commit, لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْجَعُونَ, so that they return. So that they turn to Allah and return to Him. That is amazing, subhanallah. You know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is, you know, covering us with His mercy and rahmah and guidance. It is us to, you know, to show willingness. Allah is willing to guide us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is there to guide us. But it is human being who turn away. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us from that. Surah Ar-Rum as well mentions that it is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who has created you, and He shall bring you to justice on the day of Qiyamah. هُوَ الَّذِي خَلَقَكُمْ مِنْ ضَعْفٍ ثُمَّ جَعَلَ مِنْ بَعْدِ ضَعْفٍ قُوَّةٍ. The cycle of life, weakness and then youth and then weakness, so, and then you return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And to the, you know, the rest of these beautiful lessons in Surah Ar-Rum, it's named after the Romans, as it begins with the prophecy about the Romans' defeat. And then comes to us Surah Luqman, named after the wise man Luqman. The beginning of Surah Luqman speaks about the wisdom of the Quran. And from this comes up the major theme of Surah Luqman. A guideline or guidance from Allah to follow the wisdom of the Quran and not to turn away from the wisdom of the Quran. Right? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, تِلْكَ آيَاتُ الْكِتَابِ الْحَكِيمِ. These are the verses of the book of wisdom. And then Allah tells us about some ayat in His creation. أَنْزَلَ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ مَاءً. He is the one who sent down from the heavens water. And because of that water, the vegetation and the plantation grow. And then subhanallah, one of the most beneficial advice or pieces of advice and counsels from parents to their children comes here in Surah Luqman, and that's why the surah is named after Luqman. So a beautiful advice that Luqman gave to his son, Ya Bunayya. It is a teaching to all parents to look after their children. You know, قُوْ أَنفُسَكُمْ أَهْلِيكُمْ نَارًا. Save yourselves and your children from the fire. وَالْعِيَادُ بِاللَّهِ. Don't let them without tarbiyah. You know, let them know Allah, you know, in a beautiful and, way, in a way that will make them love Allah and love His deen, not in a way that, forcing them or, but you have to do it. You have to be serious, with love and kindness. Learn from Luqman. He began with guiding his people about the worship of Allah and the tawheed of Allah. Then Allah says, be kind to your parents. You have to respect them and to love them and to obey them, unless they will command you to disbelieve or make shirk. And then subhanAllah, something here is very beautiful for reverts and new Muslims. You know, Allah says, even if your parents, they strive, they make jihad. You know, one of the words of jihad are mentioned here. They make jihad against you to leave Islam. still don't obey them in that, but وَصَاحِبَهُمَا فِي الدُّنْيَا مَعْرُوفًا, and accompany them in the dunya with ma'ruf. Allah didn't say leave them and ignore them or neglect them. Allah says even if they are fighting against you, fighting with you to make kufr, you know, don't obey them in that, but keep a relationship between them. Ma'ruf, accompany them, keep friendship with them. Subhanallah, ajib, that's amazing. To the rest of this nasiha, you know, some other adab about ethics and moralities that Luqman teaches to his son. Allah mentions in Surah Luqman, one of the main reason why people miss guidance and light. Why people are misguided. Allah mentions here that they are being blinded by following their forefathers. They just say, we're going to follow our fathers, our forefathers. This is one of the, you know, obstacles that people miss the way of, you know, light and guidance. So if the truth speaks and it truth is there, you have to accept it. Even if you're going to disagree with your beloved ones. Then Allah mentions here that if all the trees were pens and oceans were ink, Allah's words would remain and the oceans and trees would perish and would be exhausted and finish. Allah concludes the surah with a beautiful conclusion about some of the keys of the unseen. It is Allah who knows when the sa'a or the day of judgment is going to be established. It is Allah who knows your risk. It is Allah who knows you, what is in the wombs of the women. So to the rest, inna Allaha alimun khabir. Then comes to us Surah As-Sajda. It's named after, Surah As-Sajda is named after the prostration because it has sajda. So the Surah As-Sajda begins with mentioning that the Quran contains no doubt. La rayba fihi min rabbil alamin, from the Lord of all the worlds. The Quran is from Rabbil Alameen. This has been mentioned, manifested, reinforced, you know, in so many verses. Oh mankind, oh humanity, the Quran is from the Lord of the worlds. Subhanallah. So pay attention to that. And it has zero doubt, no doubt. And then Allah says, Subhanahu wa ta'ala, he tells us about the Genesis or the beginning of creation, how he created Adam alayhi salam. And he speaks about the day of judgment. One day in the sight of with Allah is equal to 1,000 day of hours. And imagine the day of judgment is 50,000 years. Subhanallah, it's going to be a very long day. May Allah make it easy. That's why as the day of Friday, the Sa'a, the day of Qiyamah, will be established on Friday. Right? It is the best day on which the sun rises, the best day in which the sun sets, and it is the same day that Allah created Adam, and we are coming from Adam. And Allah speaks about Genesis, and that's why it is sunnah, masnoon, not fard, or compulsory. It is masnoon to recite in Salat al-Fajr, Surat al-Sajda, and Surat al-Insan. Because the Surat al-Insan speaks about the origin of man, and Surat al-Sajda speaks about the origin of man. Look at the beauty of the Quran and the consistency even in the Quranic and the rituals that we do, you know, on a daily and weekly basis. Sallitu ala Rasulullah, يعني say sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So whenever you recite Surah As-Sajda and you hear it, remember your origin and you remember the Day of Judgment. And you remember it's going to be on the Day of Friday. And then in Surah As-Sajda, Allah says, Allah mentions a specific, after the Sajda, you know, Allah says that those who believe in Allah and they humble themselves before Allah, they make sujood, right? There is a special, by the way, someone asked before about the dua in sajdat al-tilawa, because as you're making reciting, sajada wajhi lilladhi khalaqahu wa sawwarahu wa shaqqa sam'ahu wa basarahu bihawlihi quwwati fatabarakallahu ahsanul khaliqin. You should memorize this dua, right? If you said subhana rabbi al-a'la, that's fine. Right, but you should memorize it. If anyone needs this dua in Arabic and English, please do contact us. And you can Google it, the dua of sujood al-tilawa. Right, you will find it. Sajada wajhi alladhi khalaqa. And then Allah mentions here, there is a special reward for those who forsake their beds and invoke Allah with fear and hope. Allah mentions, تتجافى جنوبهم عن المضاجع. When they, you know, they get up, they wake up, you know, leaving their sleep. People are sleeping and we wake up for tahajjud. We wake up for suhoor. We wake up for salat al-fajr. Allah mentions, and we invoke Allah with fear, fearing from His punishment, and hoping in His reward. خوفاً وطمعاً, right? We ask Allah al-Jannah, and we seek refuge from the fire. This is one of the most comprehensive and the most recited dua that the Prophet Muhammad would do, right? أسألك الجنة وأعوذ بك من النار. And allow me to share with you a short story. One day there was a very simple man at the time of the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ. He said, Ya Rasulullah, I am hearing you guys, you know, and Sayyidina Mu'adh, you are making lots of dua. And I am a very miskin man. So what dua should I say? And the Prophet ﷺ asked him, what dua do you say? He said, I ask Allah al-Jannah and I seek refuge from the fire. He said, that is what we are going back and forth, you know, reciting it. Ask Allah al-Jannah and seek refuge from the fire. And that is the dua of those who wake up, you know, whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, praises here and speaks with these beautiful words and reward in the day of Qiyamah. Surah Al-Sajda concludes with also speaking about some of the scenes of the Day of Judgment, and that the Quran is similar to the same book that was given to Musa. Basically, there is so much similarity. Some Christians say, you copy Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, copy from the Bible, copy from the same God. When it comes to the stories, it is the same stories, but the Quran speaks and tells us the truth, right? So there is some similarities, right? Because it basically comes from one God, from the same God, the God of the Israelites, the God of Moses, the God of Jesus. And that's why the Quran speaks about some stories that the Bible refers to. But the Bible, all know, it was developed over time, right? But the Quran is the same version, the same text, very text that was revealed in Arabic. Anyone who wants to criticize and speak about the Quran, they must learn Arabic. They can't criticize the English, right? So, and after criticism should be with the intention of guidance, and this kind of person, even if he or she is criticizing, they're going to be guided to the book of Allah and to the Quran. Now, Surah Al-Ahzab is a beautiful surah that in which the juz number 21, or the 21st juz, is concluded. Surah Al-Ahzab means the confederates, right? Or the parties. The surah begins with a command that Allah gave to the Prophet Muhammad, ittaqi Allah, fear Allah. Imagine if I say to any Muslim, fear Allah, ittaqi Allah, he would be upset. Allah says to the Prophet Muhammad, ittaqi Allah, ya ayyuhan nabi, O Prophet, fear Allah. And don't obey the hypocrites and the disbelievers. So if someone reminds you to fear Allah, you should be reminded. Because that is something that is great, you know, from someone who is great. You know, Allah mentions here, by word of your mouth, neither your wives become your mothers, nor your adopted sons become your real or biological sons. A Islamic guidelines regarding adoption of children, right? So it's a different, there is a different world here where you can adopt children, but you know, the Islam says, basically, don't give them names that they are your biological sons or biological children. You know, you need to know about this. If any Muslim here is adopting any child, you need to know the Islamic teaching regarding that it is not allowed to call them your children, right? Unless, you know, you need to make something to give them some names, give them the names of, as your brothers, brethren in faith. Allah mentions the Prophet's wives are the believers' mothers. You know, the prophets, the wives of the prophets are the mothers of every single believer. How come a person who claims to be Muslim, you know, speaks ill about one of the wives of the prophet? Subhanallah, ajib. And then Allah tells us about his favors during the battle of the trench, the battle of Al-Khandaq. And the battle of Al-Khandaq was, you know, the confederates, people from Yahud, Mushrikeen, from Medina, so many parties, they came against, you know, Muslims and Islam to finish them off. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, rahmah, Allah's victory, you know, was granted to the Muslims, but they were shaking. They were trialed. So they were tested severely. And the story of about Ghazwat al-Ahzab, the battle of the trench, you know, manifests that. It has so many lessons. You know, if you need to know more, you need to study the battle of the trench and get to know some of the lessons here. Allah mentions here that the life of the Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the best model for you. لقد كان لكم في رسول الله أسوة حسنة. Indeed, you have in the messenger of the Prophet عليه الصلاة, the messenger Muhammad عليه الصلاة والسلام an excellent pattern and an excellent model, you know, role model for you. The Prophet Muhammad عليه الصلاة والسلام. Then the juz concludes with an admonishment and a conversation between the Prophet Muhammad عليه الصلاة والسلام and his wives, admonishing them to obey Allah and His Rasul. And inshallah, we'll continue that inshallah next episode. جزاكم الله خير وبارك الله فيكم. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our siyam and qiyam وصالح الأعمال. سبحانك اللهم بحمدك نشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت استغفرك ونتوب إليك.